In this video, we are going to learn about the vector identities. So here, del applied to twice two point functions. So del f and del cross f vector being vector point functions, we can form their divergence and curl. Whereas del dot f vector being a scalar point function, we can have its gradient only. Thus, we can have the following formulas. That is, divergence of grade f is nothing but del square f, which is equal to dou square f by dou x square plus dou square f by dou y square plus dou square f by dou z square. Then curl grade f is equivalent to del cross of del f, that is nothing but equivalent to 0. So when you apply this identity, you will get it as 0. Then divergence curl f equal to 0. Curl f vector is nothing but gradient of divergence f vector minus del square f vector. Grade divergence f vector is curl f vector plus del square f vector. So now let us see a problem here. Show that del square r power n is equal to n into n plus 1 r to the power n minus 1, n minus 2. So del dot del is nothing but del square. So del, you already know what is del. Del differential operator, vector differential operator is given by dou by dou x of I vector plus dou by dou y of j vector plus dou by dou z of k vector. When you take a dot product again with respect to del, that is nothing but we denote it this by del square. And this is nothing but dou square by dou x square plus dou square by dou y square plus dou square by dou z square. We call this as a Laplacian operator. This is nothing but Laplacian operator. So if this del square operator on a scalar, that is del square f, if this is equivalent to 0, this equation is nothing but Laplace equation, that is dou square f by dou x square plus dou square f by dou y square plus dou square f by dou z square equal to 0 is nothing but Laplace equation. Now we are going to find del square r to the power n. So this del square r power n is nothing but dou by dou x square plus dou square by dou y square plus dou square by dou z square operated on r to the power n. So now first let us find what is dou square by dou x square of r power n. Similarly, we can find for all the other remaining terms. So let us start with dou square by dou x square of r to the power n. So this is nothing but dou by dou x of dou by dou x of r to the power n. When you differentiate this r, remember that r is always a function of x, y and z. So this is nothing but dou by dou x of, when you differentiate this r power n, this is the n r to the power n minus 1 into dou r by dou x. So what is r square in general? R square is nothing but x square plus y square plus z square. When you differentiate this term with respect to x, you will get 2r dou r by dou x is equal to 2x. Similarly, if you differentiate with respect to y, you will get 2r dou r by dou y equal to 2y. So from here, we can reduce dou r by dou x is equal to 2x by 2r, which is nothing but x by r. Similarly, dou r by dou y is nothing but y by r, and dou r by dou z is nothing but z by r. So in the place of dou r by dou x, we are going to replace it by x by r. So this is equivalent to dou by dou x of n r to the power n minus 1 into x divided by r. So this you can rewrite it as dou by dou x of n r to the power n minus 2 into x. So now again we are going to differentiate this term. When you differentiate this term, n is common. Let us have it as it is. Here it is a product of two functions. So r to the power n minus 2 into differentiation of x is nothing but 1. Then plus x times, when you differentiate this r to the power n minus 2, it is n minus 2 r to the power n minus 2 minus 1, that is n minus 3 into the differentiation of r is dou r by dou x. This dou r by dou x is nothing but x by r. So this is n times of r power n minus 2 plus in the place of dou r by dou x, it is x by r. So x into x will be x square into n minus 2. R to the power, I can write this as n minus 4. That 1 by r, I can write this r to the power minus 1. So this will become r to the power n minus 4. So this is equivalent to n times of r to the power n minus 2 plus x square n minus 2 into r power n minus 4. Similarly, you will be getting it for all the other terms. That is, for this is dou r by dou, that is dou square r power n by dou x square. Similarly, dou square by dou y square of r power n will give you n times of r to the power n minus 2 plus y square into n minus 2 r to the power n minus 4. and dou square by dou z square of r power n will give you n times of r to the power n minus 2 plus z square n minus 2 into r to the power n minus 4. Therefore, so here we have found what is dou square by dou x square of r power n, then dou square y square, dou square by dou y square of r power n, and dou square by dou z square of r power n. So therefore, we can find del square r power n is equal to n, that is 3 n times of r power n minus 2 plus n into n minus 2 times r power n minus 4. So n is common, so it has to come to the second term also. So it is n into n minus 2 r to the power n minus 4 into x square plus y square plus z square. So we know that x square plus y square plus z square is equal to r square. Therefore, it is del square r power n will be equivalent to 3n r to the power n minus 2 plus n into n minus 2 r power n minus 4 into r square. So this will give you 3n r power n minus 2 plus n into n minus 2 r to the power n minus 2. So in the both the terms, n into r power, so n into r to the power n minus 2 is common. So if you take n r power n minus 2, the remaining will be 3 plus n minus 2. So this will give you n into, so 3 plus n minus 2 is nothing but n plus 1. Therefore, it is n into n plus 1 r to the power n minus 2. Therefore, we have arrived at the result del square r power n is equivalent to n into n plus 1 into r power n minus 2. So this is the answer for this problem. Right? Now we'll move on to the next problem. Find the value of A if the vector has zero divergence. What is the meaning of that? It is given that it has zero divergence. That is nothing but del dot product F vector equivalent to 0. If it is so, then we are supposed to find the value of A. So now let us find what is del dot F vector and then equate that to 0 for getting the value of A. That is dou by dou x of the first term. I am just writing it directly. So it is A x square y plus y z, then plus dou by dou y of x y square minus x z square, then plus dou by dou z of 2 x y z minus 2 x square y square equivalent to 0. So when you differentiate this term partially with respect to x, you will get 2ax into y. Then plus the second term, you are going to differentiate with respect to y. So this you will get it as 2x into y. And the third term, you are going to differentiate with respect to z. So when you differentiate that with respect to z, you will get 2 times xy equivalent to 0. So this is nothing but 2axy is equal to minus 4xy. Okay. So this is nothing but, when you divide this by 2xy, you will get a is equal to minus 2. Therefore, the value of a is nothing but minus 2. Once you find the value of a, we need to find the curl of the above vector which has the zero divergence. So in the place of a, we are going to replace it by minus 2. Therefore, the f vector will be written as minus 2 x square y minus 2 x square y plus yz I vector, then plus xy square minus xz square j vector plus 2xyz minus 2x square y square k vector. Okay. Now we need to find del cross f vector. Del cross f vector is nothing but determinant of I vector, j vector, k vector, then the components of del, that is dou by dou x, dou by dou y, dou by dou z, then the components of f vector, that is minus 2 x square y plus y z, then x y square minus x z square, then 2 x y z minus 2 x square y square. So when you expand the determinant, this is nothing but I vector times of dou by dou y of this term. Dou by dou y of this term is nothing but 2 x z minus 4 x square y, then minus dou by dou z of this term. So differentiate this term partially with respect to z, will give you minus 2 x z, then minus j vector times dou by dou x of this term will give you 2yz minus 4xy square, then minus, this is with respect to j vector, so this is a differentiation with respect to x, then differentiation of this term with respect to z will give you plus y, okay, then plus k vector times of, differentiate this with the partially with respect to x will give you y square minus z square, then minus dou by dou y of this term will give you minus 2x square. So, this is a differentiation with respect to y, right. So, this is minus 2x square plus z. So, this is equivalent to I vector times here 2xz minus into minus will give you plus 2xz. So, this is 4xz minus 4x square y. Then minus j vector times 2yz minus 4xy square minus y. Then plus k vector times y square minus z square plus 2x square minus z. So here 2yz minus 4xy square minus y and k vector y square plus 2x square minus z and here is z square. So let me check this again. So this is k vector times differentiation of this term with respect to x will give you y square minus z square. Then minus differentiation of this term with respect to y will give you minus 2x square, then plus z, okay. So, this will give you, okay. So, this is correct, right. So, we will stop with this. Thank you.